In a paravirtualized setting, on the other hand, the operating system knows that its physical memory is not contiguous. And therefore, this burden of efficient mapping can be shifted into the guest operating system itself. So now the guest operating system is going to maintain contiguous physical memory. It makes it simpler in terms of all the other subsystems to do that. But it is also going to know that its notion of physical memory is not the same as machine memory, and so it will map the discontiguous physical memory to real hardware pages. So that burden of doing the PPN to MPN mapping can be pushed into the guest operating system in a paravirtualized setting. So on an architecture like Intel, where the page table is a data structure of the operating system, and it is also used by the hardware to do the address translation, the responsibility of allocating and managing the hardware page table data structure can be shifted into the guest operating system. In a fully virtualized setting, it's not possible to do that because the operating system in a fully virtualized setting is unaware of the fact that it is not running on bare metal. But in a paravirtualized setting, since it is possible to do that, it is more efficient to push this efficient mapping handling into the guest operating system. For example, in Zen, which is a paravirtualized hypervisor, it provides a set of hyper calls for the guest operating system to tell the hypervisor about changes to the hardware page table. So for instance, there is a call that says, create page table, and this allows a guest operating system to allocate and initialize a page frame that it has previously acquired, a real page frame that it has previously acquired from the hypervisor as a hardware resource. It can target that physical page frame as a page table data structure. Recall that each guest operating system would have gotten a bunch of physical memory from the hypervisor at the beginning of establishing its footprint on the hypervisor. And so it can use one of those real physical memories to host a page table data structure on behalf of a new process that it launched just now. So anytime a new process starts up in the guest operating system will make a hyper call to Zen saying, please create a page table for me, and this is the page frame that I'm giving you to use as the page table. So when the guest operating system has to run this particular process, which just got launched, then it can make another hyper call to the hypervisor saying, please switch the page table, and here is the location of the page table. The hypervisor doesn't know about these processes. All it understands is that there's a hyper call that says, change the page table from whatever it used to be to this new page table. And that essentially results in this guest operating system switching the address space of the currently running process on the bare hardware, on the bare metal, to P1 by this switch page table hyper call. Zen will do the appropriate thing of setting the hardware register of the processor to point to this page table data structure in response to this hyper call from the guest operating system. If the process P1 were to page fault at some point of time, the page fault would be handled by the guest operating system. We'll talk about how it does that later on. But once it handles that page fault for P1 and says, oh, this particular virtual page of this process is now going to correspond to a physical frame that I own, I'm going to tell the hypervisor that the mapping in the page table has to be set for this translation that I just established for the faulted page for this process. So there is another hyper call that's available for updating a given page table data structure. And using this, the guest operating system can deal with modifications to the page table data structure. All the things that an operating system would have to do in a normal setting on bare metal, you have to be able to do in the setting where you have the hypervisor sitting between the real hardware and the guest operating system. And the three things that are required to be done in the context of memory management in a pair of virtualized setting is being able to create a brand new hardware address space for a newly launched process, which involves creating a page table. That's a hypercall that's available. When you do a context switch, you want to switch the page table. That's a hypercall that's available. When you do a context switch in the guest operating system from P1 to P2, the guest can tell the hypervisor that the page table to use from now on is such and so. That's the way the guest can do a context switch from one process to another. And thirdly, since not all of the address space or the memory footprint of a process will be in physical memory, if the currently running process were to incur a page fault, that has to be handled by the guest operating system. In handling that, it establishes a mapping between the missing virtual page for this process and the physical frame in which the contents of that page is now contained. That mapping has to be put into the page table for this particular process. Again, that's something that only the hypervisor can do because it is a privileged operation happening inside the hardware. And for that purpose, the hypervisor provides a hypercall that allows a guest operating system to update the page table data structure. So at the outset, I said that handling virtual memory is the thorny issue. Doing the mapping from virtual to physical on every memory access without the intervention of the guest operating system is the key to good performance. And it can be done both in fully virtualized and para-virtualized setting by the tricks that we talked about just now.